Crypto Nimbus is also going through. They're on its own change now. It's pure money. It's power. Thing. Silver Chair. Octo Nimbus and Sinon Helio. Velez by course trying to get into it as well. But it's pure money. It's power. Being impressed by Octo Nimbus and Silver Chair and Thing. They're in well inside the final half furlong. Molly, it's power. Thing. Octo Nimbus and Silver Chair. Octo Nimbus, Silver Chair. Thing. It's going to be Octo Nimbus, Silver Chair. Thing. They flash past the line together and it's a mighty close thing.
Well, welcome to day three. Week three, and it was a mighty close thing yesterday, wasn't it? Octo Nimbus just getting up in the shadow of the post to win the 2,000 guineas for Thunderspark, and we've got more exciting racing today. We're at Musselburgh, and we're at Navan, and we're at Foss Lass. We're also at Bath, and then we're at Kentucky Louisville for the Kentucky Derby. We've got Wolverhampton, and we've also got Randwick as well, where you've got the Sydney Cup. And then you've got the inaugural running of the SO6 Cup, which has been brought in this year by Doug, and he'll be talking more about that a little bit later on. We'll have a chat with Doug and Stu earlier in the week about the Kentucky Derby, so let's go to that now.
So, two British classics in the book already, and day three today sees us looking over the water to the Kentucky Derby, where we got Mike Tartaglia, who's going to sing these home. And what do we like to look of in this one, chaps?
Well, again, another fairly big field, and there's nothing that really stands out. I mean, we've got a couple of previous winners, and that's it. To the top, Zartax and Favourite Sun. Tricky, again, no world beaters. Hard to pick one. I mean, a lot of people in the notes are saying doesn't run on dirt, never seen dirt. So you kind of think it could be a bit of a lottery all round, which gives people like Thunderspark and Vinnie Gerard, they've only had a couple of runs, they could just be, could be anything still, you know, if they're running maidens, big fields. But I'm going to go for Moilets. You know, I know he says not test on dirt, but much ability. So I'm going to go for Mighty Bingtone.
I reckon I've got it down to two. I think Django might go very close with Favourite Son in this. And I would pick it if Winted was from Steve Rand's stable wasn't in it. And I know Steve loves to win these dirt races. And so does John Morgan as well. But Steve Rand, from memory, has got a really good knack of picking up winners in over the Triple Crown, so I'm going to go with Twinted.
That's a pretty sensible sort of call, because he does target one for these, doesn't he? I think he's put somewhere in one of his posts that when you're making your team up, you need a good dirt horse. So I'm not sure that many other people do specifically put in a dirt horse. So no, I don't. Not that that would make any difference to this race anyway, because more chance of my hair growing back than any of us three winning this. So I'm going against all my rules this year, because I normally go sort of like unbeaten horses are the ones you stick with, and this Zartax at the top is unbeaten, and I should go for that. But I've just got a funny feeling this year this is going to be all about surprises, things not panning out as you think they will. And I reckon Django's going to win this. I reckon that Favourite Son is going to win.
Yep. Good call. Yeah, his horses are up there, aren't they?
Yeah, no, remarkable improvement. Remarkable. I mean, he really has gone from zero to hero in a season, which is brilliant. Yeah. Brilliant stuff.
It's pretty good. I mean, I'm one sort of doubt about it is his horses do seem to be better over the sprint and the mile trip, and this is 10 furlongs, of course, so it might just get sort of swallowed up. But we'll see. It's one of them things, isn't it? Nothing is jumping out and sort of saying, I'm looking like I'm bound to win. So, and it's a big field as well.
These American tracks are pretty tight, aren't they?
They are.
Yeah,
Django seems to
breed his horses to run on the pace. So.
Yeah, we've got that bigger field for this that one got balloted out. I think Alex Cherry's horse got balloted out. So.
Yeah, and that probably would have been a front runner. I've noticed most of Alex Cherry's horses, especially on the hunt and the flat last week, he seems to have all front runners. So he may well have been disappointed with that, because like you say, if you've got a good front runner and a good draw, you never know. Not that I think Alex could probably pick up a Kentucky Derby, but you never know.
No, we should still be all right for pace, though, because Hans has got one in, and he's normally go off lickety-split, don't they? So that'll be going off the speed of 1,000 gazelles, and that'll be that.
Okay, so race 35 is the SO6 Cup. It's at Randwick. It's over a mile. It's the first of the big feature races that I was able to put into the schedule for this season for the low-rated trainers. So that's $100,000 or pounds. 0-8 is for three-year-olds, and I think we've got a good field of donkeys. So, and one of my donkeys is in it. It could be a wealthy donkey at the end of this race. So what do you like?
It's quite funny that you've managed to put in a low-rated race, and somehow Stu still managed to be the lowest-rated in the lowest-rated race.
Come on, No surprise.
Well, it's an interesting thing because Stu's horse isn't the only one that's come back. So you've got three horses in this race that have come back from last season. So that's a good effort.
Oh, yeah, no, that's it. No, well, I got a lot because it didn't do really anything in the close season. So I brought back. I mean, I've got horses back in Grey Silk, so that goes a few gains back. So, yeah, no, one of those things. It was more like just throw a bunch of at the flats, and I thought actually I did quite well in the first few lots of handicaps due to most of them being really bottom weights, but it didn't really work out last week. So
what are you liking it, Martin?
Well, to be brutally honest, if my horse doesn't win this, then there is something really seriously wrong. And I'll tell you why. You look at it, last week it was second, right, and it got beaten in, I think it was the European Free Handicap, which is one of the Guineas trials. It got beaten by a short head by Leon van Rensburg's 1,000 Guineas horse. Now, that means that this should be thereabouts in the 1,000 Guineas. So, if it can't win this, then there's something seriously wrong. Also, a race that probably only half a dozen of us have seen, which doesn't count, was one of Django's practice races, which suddenly appeared in Dropbox during the off-season. And this horse was in one of them, and it won it. And it was over this trip.
Interesting. So you had insider knowledge there.
Well, no, because this was a trip that I was going to run it at anyway. But to be honest, it wasn't going to be kept in my team until I saw that. And it won that trial race against a load of horses that had already won. And I thought, well, you know what, I might as well lead it in and give it a go. After the first race, it was going out.
Well, with that kind of form and obviously insider information, we'd all have to go for that, wouldn't we?
but as
not necessarily.
As we've said already, nothing's really gone to form so far this season, has it? And the ground is very firm as well. I'm not sure whether that'll be perfect for it. But certainly going on that, I don't think there'll be many other horses in that race that have been second in a Guineas trial, which is...
So well, there's any horse that's come second in the field.
It's got to be my best chance of a win this week, which isn't saying much. Yeah, I'll be disappointed if he doesn't win.
Okay, well, mine, I mean, it's a step up. I mean, as a two-year-old, it ran over 6 furlongs, so God knows what it would do as a three-year-old. So I'm certainly not going to give mine the kiss of stew. I'm going to go for Alex Cherry. His horses seem, they're front-running monsters. Well, not monsters, but they're front-runners at the moment, and I quite like those silks. So Alex Cherry for me, and Conteria.
I think Alex Cherry's got the best silks in the league at the moment, so very eye-catching. I'll make a mention for Aidan Murphy. It's good to see him come back last season was his first season. And out of the handful of trainers that had their first season last time out, he's the only one that stuck on. So, and that's interesting, he's got a horse rated at 80, and so I think he's a real big show to win this race. But I think Mr. Formula One Follis will beat him just on the post with Fredo the Frog.
Yeah, his horses are going well, aren't they, James Follis?
He's already got a few winners, hasn't he?
Consistent as well. So, yeah, we've got loads more of these coming up later in the season then, Doug. This is the first one of these.
Yeah, we've got a few more to come up, just sprinkled throughout the season.
So there you go, then, a great day to look forward to today. We've got Tim Sandyman and Mike Tartaglia doing the commentaries for you today. So we'll see you all next week for another exciting week of SO6 Online League Racing.